Morning or good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, wherever the hell in the world you are. Today we will be analyzing a world championship game of Wilhelm Steiners versus Mikhail Chigorin. So this was brought to me by my chess teachers, and this is a fabulous game. You might have heard of it because of the brilliant Rook's h7 sacrifice, but today we'll be covering every one of it, every single moves. And why do we cover this? You should listen to me. When we analyze a previous world champions games, we get better. We understand the mistakes, we understand their play style. Here, Steiners was a very aggressive player. Mikhail Tal is known as Steiners 2.0 because of his brilliant sacrifices. Steiners also used to do brilliant sacrifices. This game was on 7th January 1892, World Championship rematch. Steiners was already world champion at the time. He was the first world champion. He was already world champion. So he was playing a rematch at Havana Club against Mikhail Chigorin. You guys might know Mikhail Chigorin mainly because of his Chigorin defense in the d4. But let's begin this game. So Steiner starts the game with pawn e4, pawn e4, pawn e5, knight f3, knight f6. I mean knight c6, classical opening. Here Steiners goes bishop b5, which today is known as Ruy Lopez. Knight f6, pawn d3, pawn d6, and pawn c3. Okay, now at this point, this is the part where we analyze Steiners' behavior. So Steiners move the bishop early out. And to us, it will think that he was just trying to castle or something. But Steiners is the person who loves to attack. So he wants to hang on to this bishop in the long term, because after Black castles kingside, this diagonal will be dominated by this bishop. That's the point of c3. He's already thought that I'm gonna hang on to the bishop. Onto this bishop, and there's nothing you can do about it. G6. Black is trying to fianchetto this bishop and castle. Knight bd2. Fianchettos the bishop on g7. Now knight f1. Now here we can see what is going on. Steiners' aggressive personality. He knows that Chigorgan is going to castle kingside. So he is, how do I say this? He's rotating his B knight to come to E3 so he can launch an attack with both of these knights on the king. Castles. Bishop A4. This already shows what I have previously told you. Steiners wants to hold on to this bishop. He is not letting this bishop slip away from him. Knight d7. Knight e3, according to the computer, is an inaccuracy, but according to me, it's a great move. Because knight e3 is taking advantage of the two knights that have been left over here, and it is now looking to attack in the future, not right now, in the future. Right now, White has to solve its developing problems. Knight c5 is an inaccuracy. I really don't know why Stockfish thinks something and the human brain is thinking something else. Bishop c2. So this is why he created a little hidey hole on c2. I've told you this before. He wants to hang on to this bishop. He knows that Chigorgan will rotate his knight over here, and coming here will literally give him a bishop. Knight for a bishop, not good in the end games, though it depends on the position sometimes. Knight e6, and here h4 is the best computer move. Steiners is the person who will attack you even if he's in a losing position. Yes. Steiners doesn't care. He will attack you. He will attack you. He will attack you. Over here, there's many lines you can play. You can play castles, bishop d2, so on so forth. But the best move by far is h4 due to its personality. It is attacking the king. And here, black is supposed to play h5 and counter it, but here black plays knight e7, which is an inaccuracy, and I'll tell you why. Because this allows the pawn to go to h5, it allows a trade, it allows the bishop to use tunnel vision and pin the king. That's what he plays, h5. It's d5 by Chogogin. H takes g6, f takes d6. Over here, the best move was, in fact, h takes d6. I know g6. I know it sounds a little scary, like h takes g6, because queen might come attack like that. This is actually the best move, because by taking this, now white has the control of the entire a to g8 diagonal, which is important because the king is over here. Queen back to c6. Queen e2. Now over here, Steiner is going for a very sneaky idea. He will bring his queen here, and though this looks like it's wasting tempos, it's actually a devastating attack upon the king. Those toughest things, it's what do you call, an inaccuracy. But in those times, they didn't have Stockfish, and their brain was so incredibly powerful. I think they're more powerful than our current champions. Bishop d7, bishop e3, king h8 is an inaccuracy, gives almost plus one to white. Why is this an inaccuracy? It keeps you right in the line of this line of scope of the rook. And now the queen, according to Steiner's plan, is going to join the rook. Castles is a great move over here. Here, Steiner's delayed the possibility of queen f1 and when castles is there. Why? He connected both of the rooks. He connected both of the rooks, and more importantly, he took control of the d file. See, the reason short castling would have been a mistake over here is because the rook is currently in an offensive position. Castling puts the king in a dangerous position, and rook is basically then passive. I mean, over here, castling is just worse, because now the king, it literally equalizes. The king is out in the open. The rook is very passive. So that's why over here, long castles is the best move. It also, as I told you like three times already, it controls the d file. Wow. This is actual tunnel vision, like Gotham just keeps blabbering about. Rook e a8. Okay, queen f1 is like a mistake according to Stockfish. I don't understand what the mistake is. I actually do. I mean, like, you were on the offense, you're supposed to attack a bit more. Here the best move would have been queen d2, attacking the d continue continuing the attack on the d file. But okay, here Chogogin missed the move that would continue his equalization. Over here, he white gave up a tempo to move his queen to f1, and since it's opposite sides castling, the one king is here, one king is here, black can start being a bit aggressive. The move black had to play was a5. I mean, not a5, sorry, h5. H5 was the move. Black has to be aggressive, that's true, but black also has to be a bit defensive at this point. The rook is pointing over here. Soon the queen will also point over here. A5 is the wrong movement, but that's played by Chigorgin. H5 would have been the best move. It would have restricted the rook. But no, A5 is played. A5 is played by Chigorgin. Obviously, Chigorgin has not watched Gotham Chess video. This is a great move. Pawn D4 is a great move. It's opening up the D file. So the rook can tunnel vision. The bishop can take control of this diagonal also. And over here, black makes a mistake. This. And over here, after knight takes d4, bishop takes d4, white played his first build move. I don't know what should. It should be shown brilliant. Wait a sec. Rook takes d4 is a brilliant move. It is sacking a rook. And this rook sack is so important. Oh, sorry. Sorry, I moved a bit ahead. This rook sack is so important in this game. But white makes a black makes a grave mistake over here. Knight takes d4. I'll give you 5 seconds to spot the move. If you can't, no worries. Even I couldn't. It took me like 10 minutes. Not 10 minutes, like 5 minutes. But I spotted the move. And it's so beautiful. It's a made in 7. Can you find it? 5, 4. Okay, time's up. If you want more time, you can just pause the video and figure it out yourself. The move is takes f7. King takes f7. And now mate in 6. Queen h1, king g7. But what's the best move here now? It's not either this. You have these choices. These are your choices. The correct move is bishop h6. King f6. Queen h4 check. King e5. Queen takes d4. King f5. And it's a stunning checkmate. William Steiner's outplayed his opponent in the middle game, sacrificing a rook and another rook the game. Guy? Looks tame in front of this guy. Who is this bloodthirsty monster? And that's the game. Chigorgin is up 6 points of material, but it's a checkmate by William Steiner's. That's the game, folks. And if you want more, subscribe. Thank you. Bye.